Hi, I'm Steve Butts, and this is our video review for Batman, Arkham City. Batman Arkham City picks up a short while after the end of 2009's Batman Arkham Asylum. The asylum's former warden is now the mayor of Gotham City, and has converted parts of the slums to be a new prison for Gotham's super criminals. Naturally, things start to go horribly wrong with that sort of plan, and it's up to Batman to set it all right, and along the way tie up some loose ends from the previous game. The first big change in the sequel is obviously the setting. While Arkham Asylum was relatively open-ended, it seems positively narrow compared to the go-anywhere, do-anything nature of Arkham City. Brooding on gargoyles atop giant skyscrapers, swinging from giant cranes, and stealthily swooping from rooftop to rooftop are all part of the Batman experience, and they're all handled beautifully in this game. It hasn't been this fun to get from point A to point B since Treyarch's Spider-Man 2. Your grapple gun can even be used to launch yourself off of rooftops, so you can get from one end of the city to the other without ever using your legs. That's my kind of game. Since Arkham City is set in the slums, you won't get much contrast in terms of visuals or tone, but the whole city is intricately detailed at every level. You'll see trash cans and payphones on the streets, and aerials and air conditioning units on the rooftops. And while the city doesn't seem as alive or credible as, say, Rome does in Assassin's Creed or Liberty City does in GTA, there is a lot of content to explore here. The main story involves loads of familiar characters, including a chance to play as Catwoman, and the side quests are equally engaging. Whether you're tracking down Victor Zsasz or engaging in a psychedelic beatdown as a prisoner of the Mad Hatter, there's plenty of Batman action around every corner. Combat was one of the original game's strong points. It was fluid and varied, but not overly reliant on complicated controls. The sequel maintains a bit of that focus, at least as far as the core moves and counters go, but it tends to pile on too many gadgets. Now don't get me wrong, I love the new frost grenades, which freeze your enemies in place, and I also love the bat swarms you can call in to disorient your enemies. But when you've got 8 different gadgets to use and a handful of special takedowns, you start to feel a bit overwhelmed. That said, the variety of enemies means you'll have to learn the special techniques required to take each one down. If you're facing a group armed with stun rods and machine guns, for instance, you're going to fight them very differently than you would a group armed with swords and shields that used to be car doors. Being Batman, you've got no trouble marching into a huge group of bad guys and just beating the ever-living crap out of them. But stealth is an equally attractive option. Being able to hang inverted from a gargoyle and then scoop up enemies who pass beneath you will never get old. And when you manage to take out a whole room of guards without any of them ever seeing you, that's when you really feel like Batman. Catwoman, who lacks the abundance of gadgets and upgrades that Batman gets, has to be even more cautious in combat. And she's still able to beat large groups of enemies, but her powers and movement options require a little more thought. It's just different enough to offer a fun and refreshing break when she pops into the game. And that makes it a bit of a shame that her sequences were set aside as DLC, even if the code does come if you buy the game new. Her 4 missions are even integrated into the story. I mean, she's actually the focus of the prologue and the epilogue, for crying out loud. So while you can play the game without her and still have a good time, it just feels like she needs to be there. Arkham City is every bit as good as Arkham Asylum. Sure, it would have been nice to see a bit more detective gameplay, and yeah, the abundance of gadgets is more distracting than helpful, but the great strength of this game is that it really makes you feel like you're the Dark Knight. And since I'm not a billionaire genius who also happens to be a ninja, whose parents were also murdered, who also happens to have a boy ward, this is about as close as I'll ever get. Justin, will you be my boy ward? Be my boy ward? Why won't you be my ward?
We're coming to the end, aren't we? Can you see what I've been planning all along? You just die.